Well, so first question in today's discussion, suppose this is a plank, it is a plank okay. So, A is a man, B is the plank, right? A is a man, B is the plank. A is holding the, A is pulling the rope at passing through this pulley as per the arrangement you can see. With what force the man should pull the rope so that to balance the system? It is saying that mass of B is twice that of the mass of A, right? That is equal to 40 kg. Mass of A is just twice that of 40 kg is, let it be 80 kg. Mass of B is twice of mass of A is equal to 80 kg. So, question is, with what force man should pull the rope to keep the arrangement at rest. Yes, what will be the force with which man should pull this arrangement? Yes, what will be the answer? See here, if we do the free body diagram, this is the block B. So its weight, as per suggested, it is 80 kg, means 80 g weight of the man, that too should act in the downward direction. Okay, that is how much? 40 g, that will be acting downward. Okay, we should not consider it 40 g, let it be contact force N. Then there will be one tension force T and another one will be 2 T. How we are considering it? Because if I say T be the tension at these two part, then this part it will be 2T, as we discussed in the previous class, that in case of a light pulley there must be equal balancing forces, right? So balancing forces means here on this pulley is T plus T, 2T, so here it will be 2T, so on this part also 2T. So these two portions are attached with the block B, so that's why T plus 2T, right? So this shows that 80 g plus n, that is equal to 3 t, balancing equation for the block B. Okay, and for man is concerned, the man is pulling the rope with T, that means T force will be upward, weight of the man is 40 g and the man will experience contact force n also in the upward direction. Man is experiencing contact force N, that means man was exerting N. So second equation will be T plus N upward, that is equal to 40 g, equation number 2. Okay. Therefore, to calculate T, we should eliminate N. So if we eliminate N, that means it is equation 1 minus equation 2. If you do that, it is 800, taking G as 10, 800 minus T, N gets cancelled out. It is 3T minus 400, right? T goes to that side, so 4T is equal to 1200. So T is equal to 300 newton. So the tension with which the tension force with which the man should pull the rope is of 300 newton. This problem, drawing two different equation for two different mass, one is for A, another one is for B. But if you, as because the entire arrangement is at rest, so if you do the composite equation, composite FBD, in that case contact force will be of no use. So for A plus B, if I draw the FBD taking this way, it is for A plus B, then total forces on A and B together, this will be 2T, T and T. These two are acting on B upward, this is on A upward, and the weight will be 40 plus 80 g. Okay, in this case, when we are discussing it, when we are discussing the FBD of composite mass, that is A plus B taken together, so in that case, we don't need to consider the contact force again. Contact force will only be taken in FBD, and hence in the corresponding equation writing, provided when we are doing it for individual block. But when we are doing it for working it for the composite block, then we don't need to consider the contact force between them. So ultimately upward force will be 40 and downward it will be 1200, right? 120 into 10. So again we will be getting the answer in the same way. Okay, so I have shown you both the ways. This is for A plus B system, and this is the way you can do it for the individual. Two blocks, you can see the two blocks A and B, both are of mass m each. They are identical blocks, but they are in contact at their slant surface. One of the edges of both the blocks are vertical, where forces has been applied, but the common surface of contact, that is not a vertical surface, rather it is a slant surface of A is in contact with the slant surface of B. Surface to surface contact has been suggested. And the inclination of that slant surface is 30 degree with horizontal, right? Do you understand the diagram? So here we have to find that all surfaces are smooth. All surfaces are smooth. Then find the force, find the force exerted by A on B. Find the force exerted by A on B. Find the force exerted by A on B. We have to calculate this value. That is the contact force. We did a similar kind of question in our previous class, but that time the surface of contact was vertical. Here the surface of contact is not vertical, rather at slant surface. Since there are two unbalancing forces at the ends of A and B, so obviously we can easily understand the result of the given situation. Result shows that two blocks of equal mass values are in contact, being all surfaces are smooth. So therefore, definitely being the unbalanced force acting on the overall system, so there must be an acceleration countable. There will be an acceleration on the system. So, total system A plus B is of mass 2m. So, if I see this is a overall system of mass 2m experiencing F force this way and 2F force this way. So obviously the net force F net will act in this direction, right? So F net, that means it is 2F minus F acting on 2m will definitely bring some acceleration. Whenever there will be an unbalancing forces will act on a single body or system of particles, it will bring acceleration. So that acceleration will be F by 2m, because the 2F minus F will be F, so that by 2m will be acceleration. So undoubtedly that acceleration on the system will develop in this way, right? Once the acceleration is known, we have been asked to know the force exerted by A on B. So on B is concerned, if we consider the block of B where it is 30 degree, so contact force by A on B will be this way. So let it be small f, and this direction it is 2f. Resulting acceleration of the block B is definitely, whose mass is m, definitely having acceleration in this direction. But the force what we can see here exerted by A on B, because I told you yesterday also in previous class that contact force should always be perpendicular to the surface of contact irrespective of the direction of motion, okay. So since the contact surface is this one, so contact force by one on the other will be along the line perpendicular to the surface of contact. So that's why it is this way. So now this contact force can be, as per requirement, as the acceleration suggested, horizontal in direction. So that therefore the use of this force need to be, this force need to be resolved in these two components. Geometrically this line and this line parallel, this is being the transversal, okay. So we can see this is 30 degree, means this angle will be 30, so this angle will be correspondingly 30, yes or no? This angle will be 30 degree, right? Could you follow this geometry? Because if I draw a line like this, okay, 30, 60, this will be, just a minute, yeah, 60, 30, this will be 30. So downward will be F cos 30 and horizontal it will be F sin 30. So that means by A on B along horizontally rightward it will be F sin 30, and to the left in the direction of acceleration the block B is experiencing 2F, okay. So therefore we can write down 2F is the force in favor of motion minus F sin 30, so that will be equal to M into A. So therefore 2F minus sin 30 is 1 by 2, that is equal to M into A. A we got it as F by capital F by 2M, so therefore MM gets cancelled out. So it is small f by 2, that is equal to 2F minus F by 2. So that means this is 3F by 2, got it? So small f is equal to 3f. This implies that small f is equal to 3f. So contact force being perpendicular to the surface of contact, so it will be magnitudically 3f. Okay, so this is a width d, suppose an object is pulled from a ditch whose depth width is d, it is pulled by, it is pulled out of the ditch by the help of two equal forces as per the arrangement shows, right? So the block or the object which is pulled out is of mass m. Initially it is at a height, it is at a depth h below the level where it is pulled horizontally. The free ends of the string pulled horizontally at both ends. According to the diagram, it is a symmetrical arrangement in order to pull the mass out of the ditch. Initially it is at a depth h. Now question is, so will it be possible by these two force to be applied constantly in order to pull it out of the ditch? Is it possible by applying constant force the mass m can be pulled outward? My question is, could you follow the question? Is it possible to pull the mass outward by applying constant force at both ends? Rogers is saying no. Based on which argument? How will you establish that? That it can't be pulled out by applying constant force at both ends? If I consider your answer, then the applied force need to be increasing, right? Due to change in angle, correct? Absolutely correct. Due to change in angle, we can say at the initial position, if I draw this is the vertical line through the point where the mass m is, initially this will be at d by 2 from either of the side. If I take these two angles as theta each, right, then the force F applied means here it is F, here also it is F. So being two diverging equal forces, this F at the free ends means it is nothing but the other than the tension developed in the string. So these two theta values indicating that upward force will be 2F cos theta and their horizontal components will be F sin theta each, right? So these F sin theta forces will be getting cancelled out, and here we can see the block of mass m, that means weight mg is acting vertically downward. So 2F cos theta is the upward force, mg is the downward force, right? So to pull upward, to pull the mass vertically upward, okay, 2F cos theta, this need to be greater than equal to mg. 2F cos theta need to be greater than equal to mg, otherwise it is not possible to pull the mass out of the ditch moving vertically upward. So this implies that F should be greater than equal to mg by 2 cos. Increase in theta means cos theta will decrease. That implies that cos theta will decrease. Okay, so as cos theta being the denominator term of the force deciding expression, so with the decreasing in denominator, numerator is constant, implies that applied force will increase. Could you follow this? Is that clear? So as the two different men will like to pull the free ends of the string to take the mass out of the ditch, that means that applied force at the both ends must be continuously increasing in the process when it is being pulled vertically upward. And if the applied force does not increase, then it is not possible by in this process to pull the block out of the ditch. Got my answer? Could you follow the explanation with the proper reasoning? The mathematical equation suggests that proper reasoning. Do you understand the diagram? Here it is showing that this is a horizontal surface. So A and B are two blocks of mass 5 kg and 10 kg. They are connected by a light string which is passing over the groove of a smooth pulley, and that is further connected to another string whose one end is fixed here, right? One end is fixed here on this surface, and now some force is applied on the pulley 1. If I mark it 1, this is pulley 2. So the string passing over the pulley 2 is connecting block A and B. Applied force is time dependent force that I have given, 2t plus 4 newton. So I want to know, find the time when due to the applied force it is possible to lift the blocks A and B from the surface of contact. Could you follow this question? We can see both the blocks A and B are in contact with the floor or with the surface, and in this arrangement it is the pulley 1. Both the pulleys are light pulleys in extents, okay, light pulley. Strings are used, they are also light string, inextensible in length. Okay, so pulley 1 is pulled vertically upward with variable force. It's a time dependent force, means it is a variable force, right? So because of this variable force, at what time, that means at which instant, it is possible by the external agent to lift block A and block B from the surface of contact? Okay, so first of all, if I do the free body diagram of A, so for A it is 5g, there will be tension T, right? On the other hand, the block B, which is having 10 kg, so 10g, that too will have the same tension because these two strings are same. So tension will be T each. So if T being the tension, so on this pulley downward effect will be 2T, so here it will be 2T. So that means here also it is 2T. Got it? So that means the force applied on the pulley, therefore F is equal to 2T plus 2T, it is 4T, right? It is 4T. The value of F should be 4T. Now question arises, To lift A, the T value, the approaching value of T should be equal to 5g. So when T will be 5g, then F will be, being F being 4 times T, So it will be 4 into 5g means 200 Newton. Okay. So F as being time dependent relation is this. So therefore it is 2t plus 4 will be 200. So 2t will be 196. Right? 2t will be how much? 196. So the time t will be definitely 98 seconds. So at 98 second, the first block, which is relatively a lighter one, okay, at 98 second it will be the 5 kg block that can be lifted from the surface of contact. Okay, but on the other hand, to lift block B, being it is of mass B is 10 kg, so tension force has to be 10g, means it will be 100 Newton, right? When tension in this portion of the string will be 100 Newton, that then we can expect B to be lifted. So therefore, applied force, which is always 4 times the tension developed, so it will be 400 Newton. So force 2t plus 4 need to be 400, 2t plus 4 need to be 400. So again 2t will be how much? 396. Got my point? So t will be, so therefore t will be how much? 396 by 2. Yes or no? Could you follow this? So the instant when 5 kg block will be lifted, that is 98 second, and when it will be the 10 kg block will be lifted, it is 198 second. Isn't it? Could you follow the answer? So Prathamesh, you have written at 98 second both blocks will be lifted, so it is no, at 98 second it will be only 5 kg block that can be lifted. When the 10 kg block is to be lifted, that time the time will be 198 second, and when this will happen, what will be the state of block A? When A is about to lift, that is 98 second, at that time nothing has been done in order to leave the contact for 10 kg block, right? But the moment when 10 kg block is made to be leaving the contact, at that time what will be the status of A? So as per FBD of A, when t becomes how much? 100 Newton, weight of block A is 50 Newton, so that time there will be a resulting acceleration found on the block A at the moment when B is about to leave the contact, and this acceleration of block A will be the difference in force by mass. Tension force upward is 100, weight of the block A is still 50, so 100 minus 50 will be 50, the net force divided by mass, so acceleration will be 10 meter per second square. It can be asked in this way, that what will be the state of acceleration of the block A when block B is about to leave the contact? So answer is, when block B is about to leave the contact, because of this time varying effort, it will be the block A moving upward with an acceleration of 10 meter per second square. Are you getting the concepts?